good morning, Destiny Cebu! Ayun, pwede ba itong manduol tanan and fill the spaces here in front? Yan, while waiting for the others, no, nga muari and fill that reserved seat for them. So, question lang. Question that we would like to ponder on. How many of you here sinned? Kasi mga nakasala. Yes! Every one of us, really, right? Every one of us sinned. And we fall short of the glory of God. So, daghan sa ato, daghan mga binabitbit nga sala. And even others are still bringing it and doing it. But, sa katungan mga sala na ingan sa Romans, the wages of sin is death. And we all deserve death. Kana imong katapat karon, we all deserve to die because of our sin. But amazingly, naigibuhat nga amazing ang atong Ginoo. He gave His one and only Son to die for our sins, to pay for all of our sins. And He has defeated the grave and He was able to save us all, and that is Jesus Christ. Makita na nato sa cross, no? That cross, dito giluwas ta sa atong nag-inusarang Ginoo. And amazingly, wow, ngano man, makapangutan na ka, ngano man, nga giluwas ko ni Lord, nga makasasala ako, badlungan ko, bisan pag-unsaan nga, ay, lagi na buhata, buhaton kihapon, magbalik-balik sa sala. But you know what, despite all that, our loving God saved us from our sins because of His unconditional love nga iyang gihatag sa atoa. And it is not just an unconditional love. It is a perfect love nga walay laing makahatag. So grabe, no? Ingon ana, kadako o ka-amazing ang gibuhat sa atong Ginoo para kanato. And right now, kung may inana nga amazing kaya atong Ginoo maka-adto ta kaniya, we will be able to praise and worship Him without anything ang gihuna-huna. Peaceful, haruhay ang tanan, wala kay gihuna-huna nga problema, wala kay mga gihuna-huna nga makadistract sa imo sa imong focus sa Ginoo. Pero nata diri sa kalibutan. And remember, Jesus said, there will be tribulations. There will be battles every single day nga atong atubangon. But He just said, in that battles, we just have to surrender it all to the Lord. That battle is not for us to win. That battle belongs to the Lord. Kaya kung kita lang, we cannot win it. We are limited beings. Narigitay, mga sa Tagalog pa, hangganan. But with God, with His presence, surrendering it to the Lord, makadaog yuta. We will win this battle in this world. So guys, how amazing it is, no, to have a God who is strong, who is mighty. And karon sa imong life, I believe each one of us are going through battles. Kinsa ang imong gibutang sa atubangan to fight that battle? Is it yourself or is it God? Are you making room for God or are you just doing and controlling everything on your own? So remember, no, God saved you and you are not your own now. You are a child of God. Kana imong katampan. That's a child of God. Bisag unsa man nakabadlong. He is or she is a child of God. And when we are a child of God, of course, we will be proud. We will be secured that we have a mighty God nga makaatubang sa any challenge. So if you are going through something right now, surrender it to the Lord. That's the best and greatest weapon that you can use. Surrendering to God. So right now, let us all stand. And let's just give a wonderful praise to the Lord. Sa ato ang mighty nga Ginoo nga naghatag nato og gift, which is the gift of grace. So we just have to believe and receive it. Right now, receive it with all your heart. All right, guys. Can I hear an amen? All right. Let us sing worship to the Lord. Now I see grace. Hallelujah, I stand amazed. I'm staring at an empty grave. Come on. and the stone that you rolled away. When I was a prodigal, you saw the sun. When I left the 99, you saw the one. And just like that, all my past has been erased. When I look back, come on, I see grace. I see shame, all short of what you say I'm worth. Devil says I don't deserve what you did at the cross. He's right beside, but you did it anyway. Praise. Come on, shout your praise to the Lord. Now I'm standing thanking God it's behind me. Cause I've seen Dale cross and reach out and wipe it all away. Hey, now I see grace. Hallelujah, I stand amazed. I'm staring at an empty grave and a stone that you rolled away. When I was a prodigal, you saw the sun. When I left the 99, you saw the one. And just like that, all my past has been erased. When I look back, I see grace. I still hurt, fall short of what to say I'm worth. The devil says I don't deserve this right brightest God, cause I don't deserve. But you did it anyway. I see grace, hey! Hallelujah, I stand amazed. Come on! I'm staring at an empty grave, at a storm that you rolled away. When I was a prodigal, you saw the sun. When I left the 99, you saw the one. Just like that, oh, my path has been erased. When I look back, I see grace, grace, God's grace. Grace that is greater than all my sin. Thank God Almighty, gonna sing again. I see grace, grace, God's grace. Grace that is greater than all my sin. I see grace, hallelujah, I stand amazed. I'm staring at an empty grave and a stone that you rolled away. When I left the 99, you saw the ones. Just like that, all my past has been erased. When I look back, I see grace, grace, God's grace. Grace that is better than all my sin. Thank God Almighty, gonna sing it. I see grace, grace. Come on, continue clapping your hands to the Lord. Hey! How amazing it is to be in God, who's mighty, who's strong, worthy of our praise. Hey!
You were at home in my heart, cause you loved me right from the start. When I was refusing,
hey!
Your love kept pursuing.
1, 2, 3, go!
Now that I've tasted your love, my heart just can't get enough. Jesus, you have me. You have me complete. It's your love in my heart running over. Yeah. Every day of my life, I draw closer. Such a perfect love, oh, you lift me higher, higher, lighting up my way. Everything is brighter, brighter with you. Everything is better for walk in this perfect love. Lord, I keep my eyes fixed on you, 'cause Jesus, you're faithful, and you are able. Now it's your love in my heart running over. Every day of my life, I'm gonna draw closer to you. Such a perfect love, oh, you lift me higher, higher, lighting up my way, everything is brighter, brighter, with you, everything is better.
Lord, you are welcome in my heart. Oh yeah. Come on, clap your hands there. Invite the Lord into your heart. You are welcome. Come on, shout the name of the Lord Jesus. Hey, Jesus. You are welcome. Come on, clap your hands in the air. Shout the name of the Lord, such a perfect love.
Oh, you lift me higher, higher, lighting up my way. Everything is brighter, brighter. We know everything is better, so much better. In His perfect love.
Hey! Yes, Lord! Come on, give a clap of praise to the Lord! Yes, God, indeed you have a perfect love, O Lord, and we see that grace, that free gift, O God, that you have given us, O Lord. Remind us always, O God, that in every battle that we are going through, we are surrendering it all to you, O Lord. Battling it in prayer, communicating with God.
Jesus. belongs to you, and every fear I lay at your feet. I'll sing through the night, oh God, the battle belongs to you. Before us, nothing can stand against the power of our God. You shine in the shadow, you win every battle.
Yes, Lord.
Nothing can stand against the power of our God.
Almighty fortress,
you go before us.
Come on.
Nothing can stand against the power of our God. You shine in a shadow, you win every battle.
Every battle that we have.
Nothing can stand against the power of our God.
Come on, Almighty Fortress. You go before us, Lord. Hey.
Nothing can stand against the power of our God. Shine in a shadow, you win every battle.
Hey!
Nothing can stand against the power of our God. Almighty fortress, you go before us.
Come on, declare this.
Nothing can stand against the power of our God. You shine in a shadow.
To do
whatever you want to, and I will make room for you, Jesus, to do whatever you want to, to do whatever you want to. And here is where I lay it down, every burden, every ground. This is my surrender, this is my surrender. And here is where I lay it down, every lie and every doubt. This is my surrender, and I will make room for you, oh Lord, to do whatever you want to, to do whatever you want to. And I will make room for you, oh, to do whatever you want to, to do whatever you want to. Lay it all down. And here is where I lay it down, every burden, every ground. This is my surrender, this is my surrender. And everywhere I lay it down, every lie and every doubt, this is my surrender.
Break down the walls of all my religion. Go away.
whatever you want to. And do whatever you want to. Make it a declaration, church. I will make room to you, God. Do whatever you want to. Do whatever you want to. Come on, one more time, church, louder. I will make room for you, Jesus. Jesus, do whatever you want to. And do whatever you want to. One last time. I will make room for you. And do whatever you want to. Do whatever you want to. Here is where I lay it down. You are the one I'm chasing now. This is my surrender. This is my surrender. Lay it all down to the Lord. Come on, run after God. This is my surrender. This is my... Oh, one more time. Where I lay it down. You're all I'm chasing now, Lord. And this is my surrender. And this is my surrender.
Let's just continually be in the presence of God this morning as we continue our worship. Let's just make room for God this morning. Let's just make room for God in our minds this morning. Let's just make room for God in our hearts this morning. Maybe for the past days, and maybe for the past months, you have been carrying something. You've been trying to make ends meet. You have this plan. You're trying to control the things in your life, your finances, your family, your career, maybe your husband, maybe your wife, your children. The song that we just sang is telling the Lord, Lord, have your way in my life. Maybe it's not a burden, but maybe you're experiencing words of discouragement. You are hearing voices that are not from the Lord. Or maybe you hear the voice that tore your confidence, maybe a hurt from someone. Maybe a rejection from a friend, or maybe a critic from a boss. I believe karong buntaga, God wants us to make room for Him. What does it mean to make room for Him? It means to give God space to move in our lives, to allow Him to work His way. When we finally are at the end of our road, sa nanata sa point, gagikapoy na ta, dili na ta kay balo, unsaon ang mga bagay-bagay, we have already done our part. I believe what God is wanting from us this morning is to make room for Him. And what does it mean to make room for Him? It's like a feast wherein God cannot give you something because nakakumot pa ang imo mga kamot, nakaklose. And we have to let go whatever these things that we're trying to control. We have to let go of every burden, of every crown, of every doubt, of every lie, of every anxiety. And then just open our hands to God and say, Lord, I make room for you. And so this morning, why don't we do that? And as an act of us making room for God, just surrendering to the Lord all. You know, God wants us to surrender our all to Him. He wants us to carry our burdens. He wants us to carry through. He wants us to surrender to Him because He has great plans for all of us. But we cannot experience His plan up until we try to hold control of these things. We need to let go. And we need to let God and allow Him to have room in us. To sing the song, I will make room for you. It does not mean no nga naalantay gamay nga kwarto sa atong kinabuhi. And Lord, dira ra ka. The song means, God, take possession of my life. God, come dwell with it. May this body, may this life be your temple, God. This whole heart of mine, Lord, is your room, and have your way. And that is the song, that is what the song is all about. So right now, as an act of surrender, whatever you have in your mind, whatever you're holding on tightly, why don't we just, in our act of surrender, just open our hands, or open our palms to God as our act of telling the Lord, Lord, here is my physical expression of just making room, allowing you to move in my life. And then just unload everything before the Lord. Every burden, every crown, every doubt, every anxiety to God. Let's just make room for God. And then isurrender lang nato tanan na naa nato karon sa iya.
Break down the walls of all my religion. You're
morning, we just make room for you, Lord. A special place, Lord, carved, Lord, in our innermost being, Lord, for you and you alone, God. And Lord, this morning, God, make our lives a room for your word to dwell, Lord. Lord, we make room, Lord, for your joy in our lives, for your peace, Lord, for your security, for your assurance, God, for your move in us, Lord, and all around us, Lord, sa among mga pamilya, Lord, sa among career, God, Lord, sa among future, God, we make room, God, and we believe, Lord, we surrender to you because we know, Lord, that your way is better. Your way is better, God. And we thank you, Lord, that you are a God in whom your ways are higher than our best plans, God. And even, Lord, if ang ayong among kinabuhi, Lord, kay murag gubot na, Lord, ang imong trono nagpabilin. And bisag gubot may karon, Lord, we know that you will see us through. And continually, Lord, dwell within us, not just this morning, but with the rest of our days. We just give you, Lord, all the praise, all the honor, all the worship. And church, everybody say, amen. Let's give the Lord a clap. Amen, amen. So, before we take our seats, why don't we just make room as well for, you know, to just be with our friends, no? You just roam around and magkumustahan lang ta. Just ask them how they are doing, no? Everyone, so before we continue, pwede ba na ito tawagon tanan ng mga bata, no? Maari lang sa front, and ato silang ipag-pray. Tanan ng mga bata and mga kids, 18, 17 and below. Ato lang silang ipag-pray karon. O, asa na mga bata karon dire? No, calling all the young ones. Sige. Ang mga bata karon, no? Kaya murag din ang mga bata. Anyways, why don't we just pray for them, no? As we release them, let's just extend our hands. Say, Ilaha, Lord, we just thank you for these kids. We just thank you, Lord, for the wonderful blessing of children. And Lord, allow them to know that you love them so much. Allow them, Lord, in their limited minds and views, Lord, to see an unlimited God at work in their lives. Even, Lord, be with their teachers. As Lord, sila, Lord, magtudlo sa ilaha. And Lord, gamita sila na i-form ang kaninga mga bata as early as now. So that, Lord, there will be a generation who will love you. A generation, Lord, who will reach out to the lost. And a generation, Lord, who will expand your kingdom for your glory. Bless them, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Alright, so good morning to everyone. So if naa ka sa likod, I am just inviting you to kindly move forward, no? Para at least we're close. Alright, so inaim katapad nung, how are you, no? Pangutan na siya, and siguro ka nang para at least naatay a little bit of conversation. Unsa ang pinaka-memorable niyang gikaon this week, no? Pangutan na siya unsa iyang unforgettable nga meal this week and nga no. Or maybe wala pa na siya ikaw ang kaon, no? Pagkaon na naon niya. Alright, so good morning everyone. Good morning everyone. So I am delighted to be here, no? Sa mga wala kaila sa ako si James Limpiado. And I am a software engineer, but at the same time, no, I am co-pastoring this church, no, with my lovely wife. No, nga wala pa diri. So later ako ingon. But nindoto ang katong song ganiha, katong Make Room for God, di ba? Sometimes talaga murag naalang talaga yung mga butang sa atong kinabuhi nga ganahan ta naa tay control. Sakto ba? Mura ganahan ta nga kanang ang mga bagay mo go as we plan, but daghang mga sitwasyon sa atong kinabuhi nga dili mo go as planned. Parehas gahapon ang plano ato, if na-remember mo last week kay naingon ko nga karon nga Sunday si Pastora Kenny na ang mo-preach. But unfortunately ako ang naadiri, no? But hopefully dili unfortunately sa inyo ha. Kay ang natabo, pauli na siya gikan sa Australia. Basically, di na ako explain yung mayo, pero na nabiyaan siya sa eroplano. Kisa na din nabiyaan ang eroplano, no? Dagandagan siya, pero wala na, close na ang boarding. So, basically, na-stock up siya sa kanang Sydney, Australia, no? So, nag-worry me and all, but praise God, kay ang airline, kay gitagaan lang siya og accommodation, and then giribook siya. So, actually, as we are speaking, on the way na siya into my loving arms, no, from Australia. But we were thinking about it, and then we thought nga maybe gituyo talaga ni Lord, because katong paadto pa lang siya sa Australia, niagi siya sa Sydney, kaso dali ra kaayo pila lang ka oras, and then nag-ask ko, wala ka nakapa-picture sa katong opera house nga pinakasikat dito nga murag ilang iconic place, and wala na kuno kay wala na time. So gahapon ang natabo sa iya, ha, nagsuroy-suroy siya dito sa Sydney, and nakapa-picture siya, and she had a wonderful time of rest. And mao talaga na sometimes sa atong kinabuhi na ana tay mga plano, but the Lord has better plans, and that is why we make room for God, because ang iyang ways is infinitely better than ours. Pwede ba ni may inaim katapad nga, God's ways are better than yours. Tapos ina, kaya, wag pala decision. I don't know if familiar mo kang KZ, nandingan o TJ, pero. Anyway, so, nag-mention ko nga, I am a software engineer, na ako din ipakita nga picture. So, ang naay ginatawag sa kinsay na ay mga computer dere, may mga computer, no? So naay ginatawag nga virus kay nang gitawag nga Trojan horse. So basically kani nga virus kay mo enter ni sa imong system, and dili ma-detect sa virus scanner sa operating system, and then ang mahitabo aning virus gigamit ni siya sa mga hacker para mohinay ang imong computer. Kinsay naka-experience nga murag mulag na imong mouse, 'di ba? Murag dili na mo click or naanay gipanglaing gipang click. Most probably because naay naka-infiltrate nga Trojan virus. But you know what? Ang story aning nga Trojan virus is actually taken a story way back, no? Dili takay ba if myth ba ni or true story ba ni, but naro the storya na ay ginatawag nga that na Trojan nga people, and then sila kusog ni sila nga mga people, no? And then ilan ang pildihon na nila ang mga Greeks. So ang gibuhat sa mga Greeks kay naghatag sila og kana nga kabayo sa gate sa mga Trojans para ma-feeling sa mga Trojans nga murag ilan na nining way to surrender, and then gift ni nila. So pagtanaw nila sa gate na ay horse lang nga dako nga wooden, and then feeling nila nga gift ni, so ilang gisulod sa ilang gate, nag-celebrate sila all night, no, and nangahubog, no, and then knockdown silang tanan. Little did they know nga ang sude ato nga horse kay naadito yung mga soldiers sa mga Greeks, and ilang gipatay ang mga Trojans, and basically napildi ang mga Trojans. Little did they know that they were already under attack. Ang atong topic karon is a continuation of the series We Are Under Attack, and then karon ang atong pag-istoryahan kay Truth Under Attack. Can you say with me, Truth Under Attack? So full disclosure lang, give credit to where it's due. Kaninga preaching kay gikan ni sa kang Pastor Edmund Chan, no? Gikan sa katungan nag-attend ko conference sa Singapore, and ako I'd like to share with all of you. Pero basically, niana siya, nga when we talk about truth, naadaw duha nga perspective about sa truth. Number one, next slide. Pwede nato tanawon ang truth as a content lang. As a matter of kana nga naalatay na receive nga something nga fact. So basically, kuha lang siya, transfer of information. And then if ingana atong pagtanaw sa truth, sa kamatuoran, ang iyang mabuhat ani sa atong kinabuhi kay ma-destroy ta, because the more we just receive the truth and wala tay buhaton, the more nga nahimot ang prideful. Kinsa naka-experience nga tungod kay daghan nakag na-learn, next time na kay mabatian nga similar, ay kay bawa na ko ana, di ba? But when we see truth as a connection, unsa ibig sabihin na? Pag makita nato nga ang kamatuoran kay naay connection sa realidad kung kinsa ta, ug naa siya'y relasyon sa reality kung kinsa ang Ginoo, tapos ato nung i-apply, basically that truth will change us and that truth will transform us and build us up. Dapat naay connection ang truth sa Ginoo ug connection ang truth sa atoa. Else, if walay connection ang kamatuoran, truth is under attack. Karon natay ambot, if nakabati ba muna ana yung mga kanang ginaingon nga mga sentence nga dapat maging gracious ta, maging tolerant ta sa mga tao, no? Kay karon ang truth kay relative na. Ang truth karon kay depende na sa imo kung unsa imo na feel. Ayon na lang pakialami ang uban kay mao na ang ilang kamatuoran. Kinsay nakapamati na kaana, no? Nakabasa na kaana ang lines along that lines. But actually ang reality, ang kamatuoran na ay ginatawag nga absolute truth. Ibig sabihin, unsa pa man ang imong feelings, unsa man ang imong sitwasyon, ang kaning kamatuoran kay always ni maging ingana, di ko na magbago. Unsa yung mga absolute truth? For example, 1 plus 1 equals 2. If maabot na ang panahon nga 1 plus 1 equals 2.01, dako na siya nga kalisuran. Magbago ang atong computation sa world, no? Daghang mga guba, no? Because why? Ang reality na ay truth, nga absolute truth. And it is also the same way with the truth about God. But sometimes, feeling nato nga ang kamatuoran, murag, depende na lang sa atong na-feel. Depende na lang sa atong circumstance. That is why, naatay nahibalan nga mga truth about God. Pero since di mataganahan kaayo, atong i-replace ang truth ni God sa lain nga mga alternative nga kamatuoran para lang mapalipay ta and mo-fit sa atong gipangita. But ang reality is truth. There are absolute truths. So naay mga popular truths, nag-research ko ganihan, no, kay ganahan lang ko nga ma-share sa inyo, ay basig ang uban ma-shock mo nga naatay mga ginatuohan. We think nga true, pero actually, dili di ay truth. Truth lang di ay niya based sa ato mga tuo-tuo, based sa ato mga feelings. So number one, kinsay nakabati na nga dapat mag-drink ta 8 glasses of water a day. Dili daw na siya tinuod. Kaya ang reality, yes, o, nindot mo, inuno, mo inom og tubig. Pero, dili lang sa tubig na to makuha ang liquids. Pwede po sa fruits, pwede sa juice, no? So, basic ikaw ang type ko, dapat 8 glasses gugo a day, no? Para maging healthy. Di, wala po na ikamatuoran. Pero, sige, pag inom og tubig. Number two, pag mag-iani daw ka, kinsa hilig og ani-ani. Diba? Cracking joints. Kinsa nag-iana, tapos gaingnaan ka, ayaw anak, kay magka-arthritis ka. Na, wala. So na ito-to nga pag mag-crack daw ka sa imong joints, magka-arthritis daw ka. Dili daw na siya tinuod. Kani, famous ni. Dili daw ka pwede move a lot after kamukhaon kay magka-appendicitis ka. Kinsay na ka ba, Diana? Akong gi-research. Sorry, dili di ay tinuod. Dili di ay siya maka-cause og appendicitis. Number four, bawal daw ka maligo sa gabi. Kay ma-anemic ka or magka-sip-on ka. Kinsay, ginanana, diba? Dili daw na tinuod. Rason lang na sa mga di ganahan maligo. Number five, kani, related sa pagligo. Dili daw pwede matulog nga basa ang imong buhok. Kay, basin daw na ma-affect ang imong eyesight. Magka-poor eyesight ka or pwede daw ka mabuta, no? Naapodingi, pwede daw ka magka-headache. And kaya ang funny, mabuang daw ka if matulog ka nga basa ang imong ulo. Actually, ang worst lang nga pwede mahitabo if matulog ka nga basa imong ulo, mabasa ang imong unlan. Maura na yung worst nga matabo. Kani, ambot if nakabati mo ani, shaving or trimming your hair, if putlon daw na imong buhok, mas paspas daw siya mo tubo. Kinsa nakabati ana, no? Actually, dili, di gigapon tinuod. So if ikaw, no, murag, na wa nang imong buhok, no, sorry, hopeless na jud gano, wala na'y paglaom sa imo, dili na madala sa mga shaving trimming. Lastly, diri ko na shock, pag maugahan daw ka og singot sa likod, magkanimonya daw ka. Kinsay nakabadiana, dili di ay na tinuod na shock ko nga ang pneumonia caused di ay by bacterial or something infection. So anyways, naay kani nga mga truths nga feeling na to tinuod all our lives. But feeling ready ay sa ubang tao. And kani sila mga medyo trivial pa ni nga mga bagay-bagay. But you know what? There are truths that pag i-attack and ma-compromise have deadly impact sa ato ang kinabuhi. Take for example, si Ronnie Bridgman. He was imprisoned 28 years. Kaya ba mo nga ano? Ang gi-verdict kay siya, ang truth daw sa investigation, kay siya guilty of these charges. But after 28 years, nahibal-an niya nga, nahibal-an sa court, nga dili di ay ito tinuod. Sometimes, madali na ito maingon nga, no, ang truth kay relative, no. Pero pag muabot na gani sa mga critical moments sa atong life, maningil ta personally, ganahan ta muabot sa absolute truth because deep inside, we know that there are absolute truths regardless sa atong feelings. Ang reality no, kay ang truth karon kay under attack by the enemy. Paunsa man niya i-attack ang truth? Pinaagi sa deception, pinaagi sa pag-make things sa ato ang dili nun importante ang truth. Kung sa layo mong tuuhan, sakto na siya. Nga dili na relevant, pero ang reality, truth matters and truth is relevant. So paunsa man ni Satan i-attack ang truth, no, sa daghang facets of truth about the world ba, but ang kanang atong istoryahan karon kay dili lang attack on truth but attack on the truth. John 14 verse 6, pwede man to pakibasa. Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Si God, you know, we know nga siya ang source of truth, no? But dili siya ang source of truth. Siya mismo, yung diri, he is the truth. And these are the truths nga atong pag-istoryahan karon nga somehow gina-attack sa enemy nga maybe, possibly, wala nimo nasabdan nga ang kaning truth ni God sa imong life kay na-attacki na di ay and you are living in the deception of the devil. Four attacks on truth. Naay daw four attacks on truth. And number one, ato ta sa number one. Truth of God's goodness. Truth of God's goodness. Ginaatake daw ni nga truth sa atong life. Paunsa? Go with me sa Genesis 3. If naamoy mga Bibles, you can open there, no? Pero, this was the time na gina-create ni God sa Adam and Eve and okay na tanan. And verse 3, is the account paunsa na hulog, paunsa na fall si Adam and Eve sa patibong sa enemy. Ningon siya sa verse 1, no? He said to the woman, pwede na ito makibasa? Did God actually say, "You shall not eat of the tree in the garden"? And the woman said to the serpent, "We may eat of the fruit of the tree in the garden." Akong gi-highlight, did God actually say. So makita niyo, actually, if basahon ninyo, you know your Bible, sa chapter 2, klaro nga niingon na si God kang Adam and Eve nga ayaw ka una ang fruit, ang tree of the fruit of the tree of good and evil. Pero diri makita nimo, simple lang ang yawa ni ana lang siya, tinuod ba jud? Nga wal nga niingon si God nga dili pwede kaunon. So sa kaninga point, ang enemy kay nag-sow na siya og a little bit of doubt about kang God. And then we'll proceed to verse 2. And the woman said to the serpent, "We may eat of the fruit, but God said, you shall not eat of the fruit of the tree that is in the midst of the garden, neither shall you touch it, lest you die." Next slide, please. Akong gi-highlightan ang "neither shall you touch it." Kaya ba mo nga, no? Because at this time, tungod kay nag-start na og sow si ang enemy og doubt kang Eve. At this time, ang understanding mismo ni Eve sa truth kay na-perverse ng ano man. Because God did not say nga dili pwede i-touch. But here, Eve was saying something that God did not say. Hinay-hinay lang na ay na-add nga a little bit of information, but that will eventually lead sa downfall of humanity. Verse 4, "But the serpent said to the woman," unsay iyang giingon, "you will not surely die. For God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be opened and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." Imagine with me, si Satan, at first, nagbutang lang siya doubt kang Eve. Tinuod ba, Jude, nga ingon si God? And then sunod, nakita niyang hala. Murag si Eve mismo ang iyang perception of truth. Kay mura na siya na-confuse. Naana siya mga information nga wala man giingon. And then boom! It was already time for the serpent to bring the final card. Niana siya, "You will not surely die. Di ka mamatay." Actually, kay bawo ka, if mukhaong kaani, maging parehas ka sa Ginoo. Wala lang kagipakaon sa Ginoo, kay di siya ganahan nga maging parehas ka niya. Unsay gitarget sa yawa? The enemy was targeting, the enemy was bringing confusion, doubt kang Eve of the goodness of God. Ang the enemy was really making Eve believe nga si God na makak sa ilaha. So naghatag siya kanang doubt nga ang Lord, ganahan lang mga good things for himself. Ganahan lang siya nga siya lang ang makakuha sa tanan nga kaayuhan. And kinsay nakahuna-huna na ana sa imong life? Na iniabot na nga mind nga murag, si Lord na lang permi. Murag si Lord lang ang dapat may ani, dapat may ana. How about ako? And pag-iana na di ay gi-attack na di ay sa enemy ang truth sa ato sa goodness ni God. Many times, maingon ta kang Lord, no nga Lord, pag okay na akong circumstance, mo-obey ko ni mo. Kinsa na iana, no? Pag Lord, pag siguro pag kanang, pag dato-dato na kumuhatag na ko sa akong tithes, di ba? Or Lord, pag kanang okay na akong schedule kay mo, commit ko ni mo, Lord. Or kung wala na ni akong problema, Lord, kay basta, Lord, tang-tanga rin akong problema, kay maubigo ko sa imo fully. Kinsay makarelate, ana. Ako mismo, there were many times in my life nga, Lord, ibuhatan na ni, and then maging fully obedient ako sa imo. But hear me out. Si Eve, she was in the perfect circumstance. Walay problema. Paradise. But nga naman siya waning sunod? Because na-compromise na ang truth of God's goodness sa iyang life. Ingon ni Pastor Edmund Chan, "It is not about our circumstances. It is about the goodness of God that will determine if we will obey God or not." Many times, dili ta ka-obey. Many times, dili ta ka-surrender kang God. Because feeling nato, dili siya good. Feeling nato, dili siya faithful. And that's why dili ta ka-surrender sa iyaha. You know, and nga nun eh, gibuhat sa Yahwa sa ato, aside sa nga makat atong relationship sa iyaha, para dili nato ma-experience ang goodness ni God. No, malimitahan ta tungod kay naanatay trust issue kang God. Dili na noon nato ma-experience ang fullness sa iyang goodness sa atong kinabuhi. But you know what? And naapo tayo sometimes naapoy truth sa ato akan ikinsay naka makarelate ka ani makaingon ka nga ang Lord kay maayo lang sa uban. Pero sa ako di lagi siya maayo. Kinsay nakaingon ana? Maayo lagi Lord, imo lagi ang gibless si Aljun. Pero si Jeff wala gini mo gibless. Kambal pa naman ang dami. Pero ngano sa usa lang. When those thoughts have start to come in, it means that The enemy is trying to attack the truth of God's goodness. But you know what? Unsa pa ganito ingon nato sa kanta? God is good all the time. All the time, God is good. Let me tell you a story. Pila lang ka months ago, nangtawa akong mama, crying. Forward, iyang gikuan ng video, akong papa nakahilata na sa floor. Na knock unconscious akong papa, ni kalit na siya kuan. And then dili na mahinga akong papa. And then I was crying, no? And ako nang gitawag pa, nara ko sa cellphone ako sa Cebu. And then after na ako, mag-make all calls, mga ambulance and all. And then katong ning dawn na ang tanan, the thought came to me, Lord, ngano ni mag-i-allow? Kinsa maka, kinsa naka-relate ana? Pag naay mga problem sa atong kinabuhi, suddenly naadayantay ka ng, Lord, ngano? Ngano ni mag-i-allow? Lord, do you care? Lord, akong papa ba ya kay nagkuan sa imo, Lord? When these things happen, when circumstances happen, the enemy will try to attack the truth of God's goodness in our lives. But the truth is, God is good all the time, and dili lang na, God loves you. Inayong katapad nga, God is good and He loves you. Dili lang goodness ni God ang gina-attack, but also gina-attack po ang truth about God's authority. Ato ta sa Matthew 4, mauni siya ang time nga si Jesus gitempt, no? So basahon lang nato sa kaning verse 1, then Jesus was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. And after fasting 40 days and 40 nights, he was hungry. So I guess by this passage, makahibaw na mo unsay temp, unsay nahitabo, unsay story, unsay context. Basically, si Jesus gi lead sa Holy Spirit into the wilderness, no, para siya murag i-test, i-put into trial, no? And then at this time nagfast siya 40 days, 40 nights. Kinsa na diri nagfasting ka? Nagfasting ka or kuan lang imong kahibaw nga fast food, no? Kinsa diri wala nakakaon og 5 days, no? Di ba? Or 3 days na. O kinsa na diri nga, murag grabe nakakagutom, no? Kana nga, nagkurog na imong kamot, no? Tapos adto ka sa ref, no? Sa kagutom, pag-abrin mo, tubig lang sulod dito. Pagkapait. You know, Jesus fasted for 40 days and 40 nights. Imagine ang kagutom. Imagine ang, kana, and kinsa makarelate, pag gutom ka, kay murahag sa tawag uncontrollable, murahag irrational, murahag ang imong emotions all over the place. No, so this was the perfect time for the enemy to try to attack Jesus. And then unsay natabo in verse 3. And basahon nato, and the tempter came and said to him, if you are the Son of God, command these stones to become loaves of bread. So unsay una niya gitemp? Si Jesus gigutom. So basically, ang rational nga iyang way, Jesus, kakita ka ng mga bato, oh, usara ni mo nga iyang ana, mahimo na siyang mamon, or mahimo na siyang kuan, croissant. Oh. Kasi croissant, no? And sa tingin ninyo, nga ano, gitemp ni sa devil, si Jesus, nga himuon to niyang tinapay ang mga bato? What's your answer? Because Jesus can. Kita dili ta attempt nga uy himuan ng bato ngano man di man ato wa man ti powers, but the devil tempted Jesus to do that because he can. And ang reality is that itempta sa Yawa to do the things, not the things that we cannot, but the things that we can do. Ngano man, for what purpose? Para i-dismiss ang authority ni Lord, no? Para dili na ka mag-think ng Lord, and para na lang i-take ang mga things, i-take na lang ang things into your own hands. And mauna ang ginatry sa Yawa, sa kang Jesus, no nga, kay bao si Jesus, no nga, paadto siya dito sa Holy Spirit. Ang Holy Spirit ang nag-lead sa iya. So, therefore, ang Holy Spirit lang po ang mag-take sa iya dito. But the devil was trying to say, Jesus, igutom na ka, do something about it. He was trying to have Jesus dismiss the authority of God. Next nga temptation, tuluman nga temptation, verse 5, basahon na to. Then the devil took him to the holy city and set him on the pinnacle of the temple, and he said to him, if you are the son of God, unsaon daw? Throw yourself down, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you, and on their hands they will bear you up, lest you strike your foot against a stone. So, si Jesus gitransport sa devil into a high place. Ani ana siya, sige daw, if ikaw good ang anak sa Ginoo, i-prove sa ako ah. Ingon man dito daw, ingon man sa Bible, it is written, lukso daw dito, and ang angels nimo kay musaw sa imuha. If imo nang buhaton, mutuon ako nga, ikaw gud gayud ang Messiah. Again, the devil was trying to lead Jesus to do things nga wala niya gi-ask sa iyang Father in heaven, but na ay slight change. Makita nimo diri no, nga the truth is under attack, kay ang yawa, unsa iya ingon, nag-quote siya sa Bible. Niana ba siya, it is written. So basically, ang Bible, ang enemy kay bawo sad unsay naasa sud sa imong Bible. Pero here's the thing. Ang devil katong iya nang giaana, iyang gibutang ang word ni God na siya gibuhat. Iyang gitwist ang word ni God. Actually, ang tinuod nga context ana Psalms 9:9-12 ni ana diri akong basahon. Kung asa man yung quote sa devil, no? Because you have made the Lord your dwelling place, the Most High who is my refuge. No evil shall be allowed to befall on you. No plague come near your tent, for he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. On their hands they will bear you up, lest you strike your foot against a stone. So, unsay gibuhat, makita nato, somewhat na may similarity. Wala dira ang Psalms, no? But naay difference, naay gitang-tang. Gitang-tang sa devil ang context ato nga verse. You know, sa ato ah, labi na sa atong mga sabaga Kristiyano na to, sometimes, kanang kisa diri maka, mo-admit ka nga, sometimes naakay makita nga verse and then imo dayon ng ikuan mo. Yes, para talaga ni sa ako. Ano. Sometimes, kanang nga, mukuha tag mga words ni God sa Bible mismo. Pero dili na to tanawon ang context. Dili na to tanawon kung para unsa talaga ni nga passage. Nga no, para lang kaninga passage mo fulfill sa atong ganahan sa kinabuhi. Diba? Naamoy basahon, uy, murag nindot ni siya para sa ako ah. No, and the person, no, ingon dito nga, unsa pa yung mga na, for example, naakay enemy, no, tapos yan, napagbasa ni mo dito sa Psalms, ingon dito nga, God, kill my enemies. Salamat, Lord. Mauna, Jude, ni siya, akong gihuwat. And sometimes, yan, dili na to, malikayan nga, mabasa lang tao ko, na di na taganahan mo continue, kay murag sakto na niya sa ako, pero, maupoy ginabuhat sa yawa. Classic textbook siya, sa scheme sa devil nga it twist niya ang words para lang sa atong kaugalingon. That is why my friends, ako mong gi-encourage no nga mas mo grow ta, mas mo lalumta sa atong understanding sa word ni God. Because dili ibig sabihin nakasuwat na dito, if dili nimo ginasabot ang context, then possibly imo siyang gina-apply in the wrong sa imong kinabuhi. Inayong katapad nga magtuon na taog basa. Diba? And then in verse 8, ang last na nga temptation, kay gipakita niya si Jesus sa tanan no, nga kalibutan, the kingdoms of the world, and then ang glory. And niana siya kang Jesus, one final na lang. Kita ka na nga kanindot? Kita ka na nga glory? Ako nang ihatag sa imo ha? But naasya giingon, I will give all this, luhod lang ka sa ako ha. Ginatempt niya si Jesus. Kay bawo siya? Kay bawo si Jesus? Si Jesus na siya'y glory nga umaabot sa iyang cross, sa iyang resurrection, pag-defeat niya. But the enemy was not just tempting Jesus nga kana nga magdili, maging submissive sa authority ni God, but iyang gitempt si Jesus nga, Jesus, shortcut na lang. Kay, no, taas-taas, sabaya na, kinsa na diri mo naakay temptation nga mag-shortcut na lang ko. Kay at least mas dali. Same naman gihapon, ang importante, nakuha po nimo ang resulta. Sometimes the enemy will tempt us that way to take shortcuts But ang atong shortcut kay nag-end up dismissing the authority of God. You know, after sa Luke 4 verse 13, after si Jesus after na-tempt ni say wala siya naging successful pag-tempt kang Jesus. Ingon sa Luke 4 verse 13, ning withdraw daw siya and then waited for an opportune time. Basically, si Satan ni siya give up karon pero ning huwat siya and then sige lang sunod ibitake jud kanako. Ngano man because he knew for the longest time tanan nga mga tao nga ever ning walk on this in this earth walay ni isa nga wala niya nabitik. And bisa pa ni Ginoo kanin si Jesus pero track record na ako. Tanan good mabitik. That is why he waited for an opportune time. But we know nga si Jesus up until the end. Ingon gani he defeated death, he defeated sin, wala good siya nabitik sa yawa. And sa kaning nga passage, unsa ang atong ma-learn? Paunsa nato na ma-defend, no, pag i-attack na sa enemy ang authority ni God sa atong life. Pag ang enemy mi-ana nang ayaw na aljun, no. Ayaw na paghuwat sa kanang will ni Lord basta kani buhata, same ra man gihapon. Unsa ang atong response? Ang response ni Jesus, next slide please. Ingon siya, it is written 3 times. Every temptation, unsa ingon ni Jesus, it is written. It is written. It is written. So, unsa atong ma-learn, ana? Every time nga ina-attack kita sa moments nga murag ganahan, murag naatay urge nga, dili na lang ang will ni Lord, ako na lang will. How do we respond? By declaring in front of the face of the devil ang authority ni God sa atong kinabuhi. No! Because it is written. Mag-cheating ka, no, because it is written. We declare the authority of God in our lives and that is how we can defend the attack of the enemy sa truth, sa authority ni God sa atong kinabuhi. Question lang, who is the ultimate authority sa imong kinabuhi? Pag naay decision making, kinsa ba ang masunod? Makaingon bahag it is written? Or bubuhat sa ka and then sorry Lord because it is written. We should this day now we should reestablish God's authority over our lives because si God ang naay authority sa atoa because we are His, no? Kinsa diri nga mo ikaw mismo ni iyong kang God is your savior. Di ba? Right? But dili nang dihan natapos. God is our savior and Lord. So dili lang, Lord, thank you, imo kong gihelp. But once ni surrender ka sa iyaha, it also means nga magpa-under ka sa iyang authority. We should declare God's authority over our lives. Dili lang ginaatake sa yawa ang goodness ni God. Dili lang ginaatake sa area of God's authority. But ginaatake pod niya ang gospel sa Ginoo. Ingon sa 2 Corinthians 4 verse 4, pwede man nato pakibasa all together, 1, 2, 3, go. In their case, the God of this world has blinded the minds of the unbelievers to keep them from seeing the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God. Ang world daw and its forces, giblind ang mga tao para dili nila ma-appreciate, dili nila makita ang value sa gospel. Why? Because the truth about God's gospel has been under attack. Unsa di ang gospel? You know, sometimes makathing tanga God, if naay sala, ngano dili na lang nimo i-erase ang mga sala? Kinsa yung nakathink ana, no? I-erase na lang ni Lord ang sala para murag quits ta, murag happy ka Lord, happy me, happy tang tanan. Pangutana, kaya ba ni God i-erase tanan nga sala? Murag parehas kang Thanos ba? Kinsa'y katanaw sa Marvel, no? Ilang gianit, and then wag tang nataran nga sala. Pangutana, kaya ba niya? Yes. Because Ginoo siya. But dili ibig sabihin nga kaya niya iyang buhaton. Because not all the things that we can do are right. And if buhaton to ni God, iyang maging conflict siya, dili niya buhaton kay God is holy. God is just. Dili na lang pwede, no? Imagine, ang imo asawa gi-rape and then mo ato kang Lord mo sumbong Lord. Kani siya tagay ko gusto siya may ana siya ayaw na lang. Love lang. Maura na importante, di ba? Dili justice may oh Lord. Ang ako mga anak kay ginahan ni. Okay ra na basta love lang tatanan no dili ta ma-focus. Ayaw mo ka nega guys, no positive ra ta always. If ingana si God, kaya na ba kang Lord? Na, holy pa ba ka? Di ba dili? And that is why God cannot just erase, but He has a way. Pero question, pila sa inyong estimate ang way para maadto sa langit? Pila ka ways para maadto ta sa langit? Malangit ta? Kinsa maingon nga, usa lang ang way para maadto sa langit? Raise your hand. Okay, naay gamay. Okay, sige. Kinsa maingon og duha? Kinsa maingon og tulo? Or upat? Okay. So tan-aw na to, if ganahan mo, if you want to know more about the gospel, ang kadaghanan no sa atong doctrine sa as a Christian, adto mo sa Romans. Kay naa dito ang tanan no, murag ang complete nga explanation ni God through Apostle Paul. So ingon daw biblically naay tulo ka ways para maadto sa langit. Oh, shock mo no? Ah, naay tulo ka ways. Number one, basahon nato sa Romans 2:6-7. 1, 2, 3, go. He will render to each one according to his works to those who by patience in well-doing seek the glory and honor and immortality. And on sa ingon, He will give eternal life. So para ni siya sa mga Gentiles, no, dili sa mga tao sa Ginoo, wala kay balo sa unsay law sa Ginoo. Ang iyon lang ni Jesus, ni God. No? According to His works, no? Be patient in doing good. Just persevere in doing good. So mauna ang way para sa mga dili Jews. At ito naman ito sa mga Jews. Sa number two, basahon na ito. 1, 2, 3, go. For it is not the hearers of the law, righteous before God, but the doers of the law who will be justified. So niana si Apostle Paul, kamo nga nakahibalo sa law, sa Torah, sa Pentateuch, sa balaan nga pulong sa Ginoo nga gihatag sa inyo, simple lang para malangit mo, para ma-justify. Ayaw lang, pamatia, pero buhata. Buhata tanan ang Ten Commandments. And those are the two ways to go to heaven. But naay problema. Adto ta sa Romans 3:23. Nindot kayo, giingon ni Apostle Paul, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. So basically, yan si Apostle Paul, naay duha. Pero, sad to say, whether ikaw Jew or Gentile, napakyas ta na fall short lang ta. Nag-try ka pag-endure o doing good, pero if ning pahuway lang ka one day or a couple of minutes, Lord, pahuway sa kayo maragkapay maging good. Bang! Fall short na ka. Wala na, disqualified na. Wala ka eternal life. Ang sa Jews pod, wala sila ning tuman sa law ni Lord. Kapakyas pod sila. All have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. And mauni ang pagkanindot sa gospel. Gihatag ni God ang solution nga perting pagkanindota. Iya pagong gisandwich ang Romans 3:23 by Romans 3:22 and Romans 3:24. Basahon na to. 1, 2, 3, go. The righteousness of God through faith in Jesus Christ for all who believe, for there is no distinction. And then sa verse 24, and are justified by His grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. The third way that is only feasible for us, Jesus. By believing in Him, by having faith in Him, and by His grace na redeemed ta. And that is why important ang gospel, guys. Sometimes, feeling nato, no, gipamake ta believe sa enemy nga, ayaw na napagkuhan-kuhan ng gospel. Murag, ayaw na i-share kay murag, kuhan naman na, no, murag, basta, murag, weird. But we have to know nga important siya kaayo. Grabe ang value niya. Because mauna lang ang way nga nahabilin para ma-save ta. Para ma-save ang imong friend, para ma-save ang imong mama, ang imong papa, ang imong mga igsoon. That is why we have to share to them the gospel because if they do not know the gospel, you know, for those who do not believe, you know, wala sa ila ang grasya sa Ginoo. That is why, if ikaw murag dili nakakaayo tig-share sa gospel, maybe the enemy is attacking the truth of the value of the gospel sa imong kinabuhi. As part sa send me, kinsa diri ang kaibaw sa send me challenge, no? Naman dito yung usang kanang mag-share ka of the gospel. And then, na ako'y ginapag-pray kay sa amo ang dapit na ay mura siyag kakaiba kay na ay kanang unsay tawag na sa Bisaya kanay ani na ay buang-buang pero foreigner siya. Foreigner ang buang-buang. And then, kadaghanan siya nag-agi-agi dito. So, ako si pray, Lord, paunsa rin ako makuha ang tagay kong opportunity. And gahapon, nagpalaba ko. And then, after na ako pagpalaba, habang palaba pa ako, nakita na ako siya, naglingkod. So, Lord, if mauna ni, after na ako kuha ng akong labada, paggawas na ako, makita ganyan ako siya, kay akong share sa gospel. Akong librihan, no, part sa katunga challenge. And then, pag-adto na ako, wala na siya dito. Pero pag ato na ako sa Tabukto, asya rito, nagkaon sa kanang morag Julis. And ako siya nag-invite, hey, like, did you have lunch? And then cut the story short, nangaon me, kaming duha. Siya, naka-shirt lang siya, and naka-shirtless. Nangaon me dito, and then nag-storya me. And wala na ako, gi, kanang ako, anjud, no, kanang grabe good nga pag-share. But ang ako lang, gi-assure sa iya, ha, na in doing this good, na God did not forget about him and that he can come back to God. Grabe ang storya, mga 1 hour sobra siguro. And I was so happy because at last, no, I get to reach out that person that I was praying for. And dili pa human ang battle, but there's the reality, guys. Many people are lost. Some lost, like literally buang-buang, but some seemingly not lost. Some in well-shirted clothes. Some dato, but without the gospel, pag magkasingilan na, the only way, that is why ingon diri no, sa next na slide, can we go to the next slide? The gospel matters, why? Because Jesus is the only way. Jesus is the only way. Wala na ko'y lain. And that is why we have to preach the good news. Lastly, dili lang ang goodness ni God, dili lang ang authority ni God, dili lang ang gospel of God. But lastly, God's grace is under attack. The truth of God's grace is under attack. Can we all read Jude 1 verse 4? 1, 2, 3, go. For certain people have crept in unnoticed who long ago were designated for this condemnation. Ungodly people who perverted the grace of our God into sensuality and deny our Master and Lord, Jesus Christ. Unsa ibig sabihin sa grace, my friend? Ang grasya, ibig sabihin, something na ginahatag sa imo nga dili nimo deserve. Ibig sabihin, bisag unsaon nimo, dili good na nimo siya ma-earn kay ang giver mismo ang ganahan mo hatag sa imuha. And let me tell you this amazing truth. Ang yawa, ang devil, dili niya ma-prevent ang grace ni Lord nga moabot sa imong kinabuhi. Kay ang Lord mismo naghatag. That is why, kinsa diri ka relate, no nga, Kristiyano na ka, and then nagpalayo ka sa Ginoo, pero sa mamurag, napa maghihapon ang grasya ni Lord. Diba? Because ing anak ka, lalom, kadako, kanindot ang grasya sa Ginoo. But here is the catch. Dili sa enemy ma-stop ang grace ni Lord. So, unsa iyang buhaton? Iyang i-pervert ang grace ni Lord. Iyang i-twist para dili good nato ma-experience ang grasya sa Ginoo. Unsa ingon diri, no? He will use, paunsa na niya buhaton, he will use people, ingon diri, no? People who have crept in unnoticed, murag mga naakatong sa Trojan, ning ato rito, naging pareha sa ilaha, murag mga respetado sad nga mga tao, siguro ang uban, mga pastor, ang uban siguro mga naay kaalam. Pero ang ila di ay tumong. Kay i-pervert di ay ang grace ni God for sensuality. Yung sabi sabihin na, gigamit nila ang grasya sa Ginoo para license para mabuhat nato unsa atong ganahan. That is why unsa ning mga tao, unsa atong i-watch out for sa ilaha, naa na gani mga linyahan nga okay ra na kay tawo ra bitaw ta. Ibig sabihin basic part na siya dito sa mga people. Okay ra nakasala ka. Tawo ra bitaw ta. Sige lang. Or kaning mga linyahan nga. Sige lang maka-understand bitaw na si God. No, nangabit ka karon, okay ra. Si God, loving ko na si God. One day, mo-open na lang na imong eyes. Gigamit ang grasya sa Ginoo para makasala. To give license para mabuhat sa dilimao. That is why, dapat ato ng likayan ng mga teaching. Why? Because if ang grasya sa Ginoo, atong gamiton para makasala, ang resulta na, secret agent life. Yung secret agent life? Sa Sunday, praise ka ang Lord. Lord, I make room for you. Di ba? Oh, hilak-hilak pa ka. Pag Monday, di ba? In your room, nag-porn ka dito. Nakakiginabuhat, nangawat ka. Double life, double agent. And here's the thing. Sa kaninga double life, ganahan sa Yahwa, ipa-make us believe nga makamit ni mo imong kalipayan sa double life. Okay rin na mag-double life kay mauna. Malipay ka na, ma-fulfill ka na. But hey, scam na siya. Walay tao nga nalipay ever sa double life. Pwede nalipay temporarily, pero ang ending, grabe nga pag-antos. That is why inaim katapad, tigilan mo na yan. Inaim katapad, tigilan mo yan. Inayong katapad, huwag kang paskam. Naningon ni Pastor Edmond Chan, do you know daw why we live a double life? Simple lang. Because we live a double love. We have a double love. Love na to ang Ginoo. Walay question. Love na to ang Ginoo. Pero, sa atong love sa Ginoo, naaputay love nga lain. Ang atong theme song, sana dalawa ang puso ko. Diba? Mukatawa ta, pero ang reality nga na, love na to si Lord, pero love po na to siya. Diba? Love na to si Lord, pero murag love po na to kaning atong ginabuhat. We live a double life because we have a double love. And ngayon na ako maingon sa inyo, ha? Ngano ko maingon nga scam na, aside sa nga gishare din ni Pastor Edmond Chan. Because, let me tell you my story. Ako, akong papa, pastor. Akong mama na simbahan. Add to it pa, nagpuyo ko sa simbahan. So grabe, holy na jud ka dapat, no? Murag na akay mga library, books tanan, no? Na ako, nag-ministry ko dito. But sadly, as growing up, wala na ako na-understand ang grasya sa Ginoo. Feeling na ako ang grasya sa Ginoo maoni. Lord, last na lang, Lord, ha? Kay buutan bitaw ka. Or, Lord, ako ning buhaton because one day I believe nga bag-uhon lang ko nimo. Ah, di ba? So, buhaton rin ako, Lord, apat nil time nga imong i-open akong eyes. Mao na ang grasya sa Ginoo, gigamit na ako to do all those sensual, sinful things. But one day, i-allow man ni Lord ang akong kanang kadimonyuhan. Iya kong gira, sige, ana, dito ka. Nangyari ko sa Cebu, nag-live ko og double life. And then, nahitabo sa Manila na ako'y naka-friends with benefits, pinaka-grabe, pinaka-worse nga sensual sin nga ako na-indulge in. And then feeling, kanang bitong murag, dapat na ako nibuhaton kaya na ay kalipay, pero at the top of it all, murag mag-kuwang. Dili gani kuwang, lain gani, murag, dili ka-happy. Para unsa man ako gibuhat, tapos grabe kayo ko, nakasalaw ko, Lord, and then feeling na ako, Lord, dili na ako karapat dapat, no? Gihatag ni mo tanan, Lord, dili na ako dapat. Feeling ko na ako, guys, like, dili na ako worthy makasal, yung anong level. Because I have already defiled myself. But then, God restored me, iya kong gipick up in my lowest point. And then, ato na lang ikat ang story short, nakasal ko sa pinakagwapa nga babae sa Cebu. Siyempre, siya ko yung pastor, so dapat siya pinakagwapa. No? And then, iya kong gi-restore and iya kong gi-transform. And it was there that I realized what God's grace is. Let me share to you one of my life verses. Titus 2:11-12. Pwede na ito bakibasa? 1, 2, 3, go. For the remarkable undeserved grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men. It teaches us to reject ungodliness and worldly immoral desires and to live sensible, upright, and godly lives with a purpose that reflects the spiritual maturity in the present age. Unsa daw ni nga grasya? Gi-amplify, gitagaan, og deeper meaning. Unsa daw ni grasya? Unsa ingon dito? Remarkable. Pagkanindot. Unsa pa ingon dito? Undeserved, Lord. Kaniya grasya, dili na dapat ni na ako madahawat kay dapat disqualified na ko. But still, gihatag sa Ginoo. And kana nga grasya, it will teach us to say no to ungodliness. Pag ma-understand ni mo, unsa'y tinuod nga grasya sa Ginoo, dili na ka makayon nga Lord. Maka-understand bitaw ka? Because you know nga, grabe na ang understanding ni Lord. Grabe na ang iyang pagpugong. Grabe na ang iyang sakripisyong nga gibuhat sa imong kinabuhi. And kaniya grasya, mauni ang mag-motivate sa imong nga Lord. I will follow you. Dili, tungod kay kailangan na ako, but tungod kay grabe ang imong gi-show sa ako nga gugma. That is what grace is. But if you think that ang grace mao ang imong license para ka makasala, maka-understand gani ang Ginoo, the truth of God's grace in your life is under attack. And you're not living in His grace. And that is why we have to watch out and make sure, you know, that we are living and understanding the right kind of grace that teaches us to say no to ungodliness. Ang grasya nga makaayo nga Lord, tungod kay maayo ka, karapat dapat ka aning tanan. Makahatag ka, makaserve ka, mo-attend kag life group, mo-ari ka og Sunday service, mag-reach out ka. Why? Grace. Grace ang nag-motivate sa imo because ang gihatag ni Lord, ang iyang gihatag sa imo nga regalo, nag-aawas-awas. Dili, mapugnan. Lord, unsaaw man rin ako, kadagan man ani. Di ba kinsay, nakadawat og chocolate last Sunday, katang akong gihatag nga chocolate. Daghan kaayo, if naanas ako, unsaaw man ako ni mga chocolate. Di ba, if ako ni kanon, mabungi, siguro ko, akong ipanghatag, daghan kaayo, no? Tapos naimu ko, gamay ra, daghan na, please. No, kay daghan ni maglisod kog ubos. Sorry sa mga wala diri na wala ng chocolate. Pati ana ang grace. If you experience the real grace, like mag-aawas-awas sa imong pagserbisyo, sa imong pag-obey, sa imong pag-worship kang God and pag-love sa others. So, as we end, how can we win? Ginaatake ang truth sa atong ni God sa atong kinabuhi. Ginaatake ang iyang goodness. Gipamake us to think nga God is not good. Giatake ang God's authority sa atong kinabuhi. Gipamake us to live a life nga ayaw na si God. Pasag din na lang siya. Ang imo ang dapat masunod. Ginaatake niya ang area sa gospel. No? Ayaw na i-share ang gospel. Kaya anyways, no, kita mang gihapong tanan, mangadto sa langit. Ginaatake niya ang grasya sa Ginoo. Okay na na, kay ang Lord mapasayloon, ipasaylo na kaaniya, padayon nagbuhat sa imong ibuhat. How do we win? How do we stand up? And how can we say nga, no! Dili pwede ni nga i-attack ni mo ang truth of God sa akong life. I want to see God for who He is. I want to, at the end of my life, to continue to believe and live in the truth that God is good. That God's authority over my life is the one that I should live for. That God's gospel is the only way. And that God's grace is the one that will enable me. Paunsa nato? How do we resist and not just resist but stand and counter the attack of the devil? Simple lang, 3D. Kinsa sa inyo nakatanaw ng salida, 3D, no? Pag 3D gani, ibig sabihin, ang 2D nga space, ang information, na anay another set of kanang information, makita na nimo siya in more detail. Ingana sa the truth in 3D. So unsa nang tulo ka D? Number one. Ang tulo ka D kay discernment, directed action, and ang last kay dependence. How can we win? Number one, discernment. Kaya ang yawa, sige man siyang attack sa truth, paunsa, pinaagi sa deception, pinaagi sa lies. So ikaw confused na ka. Unsa ka matuuran? Tama ba ni? Sayop ba ni? In the midst of the confusion, what do? You discern. Say with me, discern. You discern the truth of God. How? Through God's word. God's word will clear out any confusion. And makahatag sa imong maujudi, dirijud ko. Mauguni ang tama. John 8:31-32, Jesus said to the Jews who had believed him, "If you abide in my word, you are truly my disciple, and you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free." Number two, dili lang discernment, dili lang ego nga i-understand nat, ay mauni ang pulong ni God. It is written, we just don't end there. Like Jesus, na ay directed action. Unsa ibig sabihin, Ana? Ibig sabihin, ang action nga imong buhaton, gidirektahan sa Holy Spirit, pinagi sa iyang pulong. Kay sometimes, kay bawta sa truth, pero ang atong action, dili, directed unto the truth, directed gihapon sa atong self. So, kinsa may mo direct sa ato ang Holy Spirit. Lord, na ako'y discernment, mauni ang truth. Pero Lord, paunsa na ako makonek? Di ko ganahan maging content lang ng truth. Paunsa na ako makonek sa akong life, Lord? Lead me, direct me. Di ko ganahan maging hambog lang, mas daghang kong na-learn, dahang kong theology. Wala ni gamit, Lord, if dili makonek sa akong life. Direct me, Lord. And allow the Holy Spirit to direct you. And as you continually obey the discernment from God, it will change you. It will transform you. Directed action, money nindot, no? Because sometimes, ginakulta ni Lord to obey, even if dili nakakita, asa ni padulong? Di ba? Believe lang, Lord, asa mo ni padulong? But ang nakanindot sa directed action, kaya ba lang taasa mo point ang God? Bisag dita kaya ba, unsan dito, but sige lang, at to gihapon ko, even if we do not see, we go because we believe. Because we believe that God is good. And number three, ang question mangod kay, paunsa ko mo ma-sustain in life? Paunsa ko nga, ang kani, and this thing with me and God, mo continue until the end? Yes, maybe madaog ka sa kaninga temptation. Yes, daog ko. Pero paunsa man nga, every single day up until ma-meet ni mo face to face si God, kay naagi hapo kay kadaugan. Kinsay, maagi nga somehow, nag-think ka sa imong self, Lord, up until kanus amang ko maging until kanus akong may obedient, kaya ba na ako until the end? Kay daghang na nag-start, pero nangawagtang. Lord, paunsa ko nga dili maging pareha sa uban nga until the end, up until nga maputay na akong buho, up until di na akong kalakaw, maadun ako sa imo sa langit, mayong, oh Lord, hindi ako. Akong kinabuhi, alang kanimo. How can we have that assurance? Nga weak man ta, nga dali man ta matental, dali man ta mo give in. And this brings us to our last point. Dependence. Say with me, dependence. We depend not on our own strength, but on God. Man is weak. Inayam katapad, you are weak. You are weak. We are weak. Bisag pastor weak. But in God, we are strong. Ang atong Savior, si Jesus Christ lang naman. Siya lang naman ang nag-stand against all the temptations that the devil has to throw at him, and he stand victorious on that cross. And he said, it is finished. And this is the God that we ask for strength from. And that is why we have to depend on God to protect the truth of God in us. Because dili na to kaya on our own. But with God, everything is possible. Why don't we close our eyes, bow down our heads, and spend a time with a moment sa Ginoo, and begin to evaluate our lives. Today we realize that truth is under attack. The truth about God is under attack. But maybe sa atoa, wala na di ay nato na naging aware. Pero naanad ay mga attacks of deception sa atong kinabuhi pertaining to God. Maybe some of us, we are questioning God's goodness. You are struggling to believe that God is good because sa natabo sa imong kinabuhi, because sa things nga iyang ginaalaw sa imuha, sa imong family, sa imong life. And you're finding it hard to surrender and to worship God because the truth of God's goodness is attacked in your life. For some, attacked ang authority ni God. You've been coming here to church. You've been attending for a long time. But when you go back home, ang masunod ra gihapon kay ang imo lang gihapong pansariling mga decision. Walay lain nga pala decision sa imong kinabuhi kundi ikaw lang gihapon. We give lip service to God. Lord, you are my Savior, you are my Lord. But when you go home, imong feelings, ang imong response sa circumstance ang mo-determine. Or maybe some of us, dati you are sharing the gospel. But karon, because of the things that happened, when was the last time you shared the gospel? Has it been years? Months? If it has been long since you shared the gospel, it means that the truth of the gospel is under attack sa atong kinabuhi. And we have forgotten ang value sa gospel, that many people need the gospel of Jesus. Or maybe ikaw, naadiri, ginatawag na yung self na Kristohanon, pero pag walay makakita sa imuha, pag naa ka sa imong barkada, pag naa ka sa imong balay, murag dili ka maitsura, lahi ka sa unsa imong gipresentar diri. Naa kay mga bagay na until now imo gihapong ginabuhat, imo gihapong ginaalaw sa imuha, because na twist na diay ang truth of God's grace sa imuha. Ang mga linyahan nga kaintindi bitaw si God, i-forgive bitaw ko ni God, ang truth of God's grace wala sa imuha, kay imo mo siyang ginagamit for a license to sin. If ikaw any nagfall in any of these four categories, but karon ganahan ka nga makaalingkawas, mabalik ang truth, and dili lang mabalik ang truth but ma-live out ang truth sa imong kinabuhi. Live out the truth that God is good and He has always been so good and He loves you. Live out the truth that God is our Lord, our boss, our master. I-live out ang truth na grabe ang iyang gibuhat sa ato para ta mataluwas and atong i-share sa uban. And i-live out ang truth sa iyang grasya na even undeserving ta gihatag sa iya ang iyang tanan. If ikaw na ang person and you say, Lord, I'm sorry na na-compromise ang kaning areas of truth about you sa akong kinabuhi and I am not living the way I should live. But you want to present yourself back to God and say, Lord, forgive me. I repent, but here I am, Lord. Change me. May the truth about you live in me and be living inside of me. If ikaw na ang person and you want to tell that the Lord right now, I would invite you to stand up from your seat and then just present yourself to God saying, Lord, here I am. Wala na ipaligoy-ligoy pa, Lord. Compromised ko. Compromised ang akong pagtanaw sa imo, ang akong life. Sa tataan nga nagtindog, let's just surrender ourselves to God. Lord, for me and for everyone that stood, pasaylo ami, Lord. Lord, we are weak, Lord. We have sinned, we have fallen short. Lord, forgive us, Lord. Cleanse us. Wash us clean and make us new. In Jesus' name. Allow us, Lord, to not just defend the truth, but live in your truth. Allow us, Lord, to discern against the attacks of the enemy. Allow us, Lord, to obey you, Lord, Holy Spirit, and allow us, Lord, to depend on you, not on our own strength, but on your strength. In Jesus' name, amen. And so for those, you may not be seated, and for those nga wala pa nimo nahatag ang imong kinabuhi sa Ginoo, feeling gapon nimo ang imong way to heaven is just doing good, being this and that. But now, na-realize nimo nga there is no other way but to surrender and to believe in God, na He is the only way. And right now, you want to commit yourself to God and say, Lord, I want to put all of my trust in you. I surrender my life to you. Ikaw lang ang only way. So sa tanan nga wala pa naka-receive, wala pa nag-surrender kang Lord, if na-adiri, today, this is your opportunity to rededicate or dedicate yourself to the Lord. At the count of three, if ikaw ning a person, why don't you just raise your hands? 1, 2, 3, go. Lord, nakita nimo ang mga nag-raise of hands. I don't know if this is the first time or is a rededication. But Lord, may they stand in your truth that you are the only way. So if ikaw ni ang person, can you just pray this prayer after me? Lord Jesus, pasaylo ako sa akong mga sala. Salamat. Grabe ang imong gugma sa ako. Nituo ko nga tungod sa imong gibuhat sa cross, gibayaran nimo ako mga sala. Nituo ko nga tungod sa imong kadaugan sa kamatayon, ako gihapon na ay kadaugan sa kamatayon, uban kanimo. Jesus, you are my only way. And Jesus, from now on, may you be my Savior and my Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Lord, I pray for those who pray the prayer. Work in them. I pray that they will be able to walk in you and have a relationship in you, Jesus. Lord, we thank you for your word. And we just would want to respond in worship. Because you deserve it all, God. And Lord, that we believe, Lord, that there are no battles, no attacks of the enemy that are far too great that we cannot stand, Lord. Because, Lord, the battle belongs to you. So church, why don't we just stand up and then just sing this song as we end our service and dedicate ourselves to the Lord.
And I will make room for you and do whatever you want to. Do whatever you want to. And I will make room for you to do whatever you want to. To do whatever you want to. Where I lay it down, every burden, every crown. This is my surrender, and this is my surrender. Here is where I lay it down, every lie and every doubt. This is my surrender. Whatever you want to do whatever you want to, and I will make room for you, yes, Lord, and do whatever you want to, and do whatever you want to. Shake up the ground with all my tradition, break down the walls with all my religion. Your way is better, your way is better. Shake up the ground, all my tradition, break down the walls with all my religion. Your way is better, your way is better. Shake up the ground, shake up the ground with all my tradition, break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better, Jesus, your way is better. Shake up the ground, all your tradition, break down the walls of all my religion. Jesus, your way is better. Shake up the ground of all your tradition. Shake up the ground of all my tradition. Break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better. Come on, shout the name of Jesus. Jesus, your way is better. Oh, shake up the ground of all my tradition. Break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better. Lift your voice. I will make room for you. Make room for Jesus. And do whatever you want to. Do whatever you want to. I will mean it with all your heart. And I will make room for you, Jesus. And do whatever you want to. Do whatever you want to. Where I lay it down, you are now the one I'm chasing. This is my surrender. This is my surrender. Here is where I lay it down. Every burden, yes, Lord. And this is my surrender. This is my surrender.
This is all our surrender to you, O Lord. God, have your way in us. Have your way, O Lord. Dwell in us, O God. Make your move in our lives, O Lord. And we can be sure that we'll be directed, O God, to the path that you have prepared for us, O Lord, to the destiny that you have prepared and made and planned for all of us, O God. In Jesus' name.
Now, let's continue to worship the Lord. Pinaagi sa giving. No? Giving is command of God. It's an act of worship gihapon. Everything we do is a worship God. Naroon ko i-share nga quotes. God multiplies our gift. When we give, we think that we are reducing our resources. Tama ba? Minsan, may isip na ito nga, marag, gikuhan man ko ni Lord. Diba? Maabot sa itong mainusay, no? But in reality, God has unique way of multiplying our gifts. As we sow seed, generosity, we open ourselves up, experience God's abundance, provision in unexpected ways. Nabot na ba sa time sa inyong kinabuhi nga, marag, nihatag lang ka ni Lord and nitrust ka ni Lord. Nihatag ka freely. Walay gina-expect nga biskan unsa nga ihatag ni Lord. No? Grabe, nabot na sa ako ang point sa ako ang life. No? Trust that God will bless and multiply the impact of your tithes. No? Ingon pa sa Proverbs 11:24-25. Give freely and become more wealthy. Be stingy and lose everything. The generous will be prosper. Those who refresh others with themselves be refreshed. So, kung bisayaw na to, ang mahinatagon, misamot hinoon pag-uswag. Apan, ang mga hakop, misamot hinoon kakabos. 25. Ang tao mahinatagon, mauswag. Ang tao nga nagatabang, ug uban, tabangan. Sab- oh, grabe kayo si Lord. So, unsa man ninyo ang pagtanaw, giving rikuan mo ni Lord. No. Giving na mga unique nga paagi si Lord. No? Pareha itong gingon sa kuan, 30 ganiya. Discernment sa sa to, discernment. Ito. Direct action dependence. Discernment. Dapat kay bauta, kinsa atong hatagan or kinsa atong iinbesan sa atong tanang tibuok kinabuhi, although imong kinabuhi, imong finances, no? Then directed action, di ba? Then dependence, and dapat na ang pagdepende na to nara jud sa Ginoo. Amen ba? No? As we give, let's pray, no? Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the opportunity, Lord, na ma-share ang imong word sa giving. Thank you, Lord, for nakakaroon din ang mga tao, Lord. Open our heart, ilang mind, ilang heart, Lord, to give, Lord, sa imong kingdom, Lord. Dili sila magunahon na, Lord, na ikuwaan sila, kundili imo silang gihatagan og unique ways, Lord, nga imo silang i-bless unexpectedly sa tanang nilang kinabuhi, Lord. Lord, we thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. God, church, let's give. Thank you.
this morning. And kisa ganahan og more. Ayon, ganahan tanga mas makabati pa more sa word ni Lord and to be with His presence. So I invite all of you na mag-join sa atong mga upcoming activities. By the way, if you have friends and family members na wala diri karon nga morning and nag-think po nga sayang wala sila nakabati sa word, pwede ninyo sila nga i-invite sa atong afternoon service. That's this afternoon at 2 p.m. So yun, invite your friends guys and pwede ninyo sila i-note. Don't miss out this very wonderful news and wonderful word nga ito ang nabatian here sa Sunday service para sila sa mismo mabless. Diba? And then, for if you are a student and natay upcoming na BSG, Big Small Group, a gathering of students. So, invite your classmates, mga friends ninyo. That will be on Friday. This Friday na siya, September 20, at ILC, dito na sa Picas nga building, diri gihapon sa UP, 5 p.m. So, don't miss out on this wonderful opportunity to have fellowship with your fellow students and of course get to know God more. And then we also have our life groups where we learn more about God as at the same time we also share our life with our friends. We have schedules or throughout the week. If wala pa mo'y life group, you can ask the person who invited you unsa na siya ang life group, what you do in the life group, and kung unsa ang schedule sad na available kanay mo friend, or if you're not available on that schedule, we have other schedules with other life groups as well. We also have our prayer meetings Monday to Friday on online sa Facebook page sa Destiny Church Manila. And every Saturday, 6 a.m., we have our gathering as a local church, as a local community dito sa 1 Kenji Place sa ato ang Destiny Center. 6 a.m. every Saturdays na siya. And if you guys remember, we had our Send Me Challenge last month, diba? Sa itong 11th anniversary celebration. Kisa yung mga nakakomplete sa challenge. Ayun, si Pastor James. Oh, diba? Very good role model. Kisa pa ilain? Wala. Because you still have time. Basta within the day, makomplete na ninyo, you can approach si Jaisal para maklaim ang inyong prize. You have until siguro 11:59 p.m. because today is the deadline of the Send Me Challenge. So pwede pa mo apas. If isa na lang siguro sa inyong challenge, wala pa ninyo nahuman or duha, pwede pa na ninyo i-apas karon nga adlaw and claim the prize kay Jaisal. And for our workers and volunteers, reminder guys that we have a volunteers fellowship on September 17. So for announcement at 6 p.m. di ay niya sa center. So see you there. And that's all for our announcements this morning. Be there sa itong mga activities. I hope to see all of you once again. And next week, see you again. For our VIPs, we have a welcome room waiting for you outside. First time, second, third, and fourth time ninyo nga mag-join today. We just want to pray for you and get to know you more. See you sa welcome room. Enjoy the rest of the day. Enjoy your Sunday. Enjoy your rest day. And thank you so much to all of our online viewers sa Facebook. Stay tuned!
Thank you for watching our online Sunday service streaming. We hope you are blessed by the word today. See you next Sunday for another Spirit-filled service. Blessings!